Hey guys, what's going on? James Johnson back in to bring you that Bleach 583. And what did I tell you about Ichigo getting a new move? Well, kind of. It's probably just another Getsuga in a different form. I guess this is the thing everybody wants to talk about, so I'll talk about it. I do have a theory, in fact. But it's times like this where the anime would prove so much useful with the colour, with how things would actually be presented in the attack. You know, the anime just did that best. Manga, on the other hand, and he's just very undetailed when it comes to some attacks, especially blasts, etc. Now, we all know Ichigo as the Shinigami. His actual Shikai is his hollow self. That is where his powers come from. His hollow is his Asuchi, so let's just get that out the way, and I'll tell you why in a minute. And obviously, Jiwa Bark or Tenzan Zangetsu that's in him is also his inner self. So from what we can tell is what we knew a few chapters ago, which his big sword is his hollow sword. Well, this is pretty much theory, and the small one is Zangetsu. So when he used the first Getsuga, he used the Zangetsu sword. And what I'm going to say is that that's probably a Getsuga Tensho that is a Quincy power. A blue Getsuga Tensho that is as of Quincy powers. Thus, why I'm thinking it nullified or just completely stopped and didn't go and attack Candice. It just deflected the blast because two Quincy powers hit each other and that was it. It just nullified. This is all theory. Of course, you can tell me it's bullshit in the comments later. And then the other Zangetsu sword, which is the hollow big sword, you know the one I'm talking about, is the one which a black Getsuga would usually come out of, thus cutting through Quincy powers. So for example, Candice would use that arrow when Ichigo used the hollow Getsuga, and it probably would have cut through right to Candice, but no, he used the one with most likely Quincy powers. So take it as you will. That's what I think it is. Two different types of Getsugas. And I'm guessing what he did with that last move, Getsuga Jujisho, pronunciation, we don't know the real pronunciation, kind of like an X Getsuga, I'm guessing is a blue Getsuga and a black one attacking simultaneously, which is pretty fucking dope. I really want to see this animated. Come on, Studio Perrier, announce something. But it's good to know Kubo knows what I like, a bit of Candice. I do like my Candice, and she went execution form, known as the bowl standing, and she looks pretty badass, I'm not gonna lie, but I just love my Candice, so I'm biased as fuck. And I thought the javelin effect was really cool, that attack. Shame it got blocked, but oh well. But yeah, this was just a cool fighting chapter. Aside from that, nothing really went on, just a bunch of fighting and these girls showing a little, well, mainly Candice, she going all standing form. I actually saw somewhere in my comments, or probably somewhere else, someone saying, you know, as Ichigo pulled these swords out of the furnace and all that shit, because this class is an unreleased Zanpakuto or a Shikai, and scenes as he's doing Getsugas in this form, it is a constant Shikai again. So now you know. Tell me your thoughts in the comment section down below, guys. Here's the comment from last week. Again, as I just said, it was just a really cool fight with lots of explosions and stuff like that. Really good artwork and really anime material. I'll catch you motherfuckers later. Peace out. You guys, of course, have been Hansen, and I'll catch you guys later. Peace.